बेटा गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. यस्टरडे वी हैव डिस्कस्ड टॉपिक ऑफ वैलेंस बाउंड थ्योरी अंडर विच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड ML6 टाइप ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्सेस. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस नंबर 2 ML5 टाइप ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्सेस. ML5 टाइप ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्सेस. ML5 type of complexes, these are the complexes in which coordination number of complex is 5. For example, this FeCO5, that is pentacarbonyl iron 0. ML5 type of complex, this one is only in our syllabus, so we will discuss its formation, hybridization, magnetic nature as well as geometry in details now with the help of VBT. What happens in case of pentacarbonyl iron 0? In this complex, iron atom is present in zero oxidation state. That is, electronic configuration of iron atom comes out to be Fe0, or iron atom, it comes out to be 3d6 3d6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And 4s2, 4p0. So this is general electronic configuration of iron atom when its oxidation state is 0. No electron is lost from its outermost shell. So in this complex, iron found to be in the oxidation state 0. So this is the electronic configuration of iron 0. And since in this case, if you look, the ligand is one of the 4 strong field ligands. Yesterday I have told you 4 strong field ligands. That is CO, cyanide, ammonia, nitro, and if you want to check 5th strong free ligand, then it is ethane diamine. EN also comes in the category of strong free ligands. So this is one of the 4 or 5 strong free ligands, CO. So what do this strong free ligand do? They always make the pairing up of electron in 3D orbitals. So in this case, what happens that this carbonyl being strong field ligand makes pairing up of electrons in 3D orbitals. How do it will make pairing up? All these unpaired electron in 3D orbitals will get paired up here, and on the same time this 4s electron will also shift to 3D orbital because of the effect of this strong field ligand. So all this pairing up of electron will take place like this. This electron will shift to this orbital, this will shift to this orbital, and this will shift to this orbital. So CO being a strong field ligand make the pairing up of electron in 3D orbital and thereby making one of the 3D orbital vacant. Like this, if you pair up all these electrons in 3D orbital, then you will see it become 3D8. and one of the 3D orbital will become vacant for hybridization. So after pairing up electronic configuration, something seems to be like this. All the 8 electrons in these 4 orbitals. Pairing up of these 4 electrons as well as these 4s electrons also get paired up in 3D orbitals because of strong field ligand carbonyl. So one of these 3D orbital will become vacant, and together with one 3D orbital, this one 4s orbital as well as 4p orbital. So total 5 orbitals become vacant. You know here coordination number is 5. 5 ligand will attach, so automatically this 5 orbital becomes vacant. So after this, what happens? There happens to be the hybridization here known as DSP3 hybridization. DSP3 hybridization takes place. That is one 3D orbital, one 4s and 3 4p. All these orbitals undergo hybridization to form 5 new DSP3 hybrid orbitals in a particular shape, equal energy and equal character. After the hybridization, then what happens? Simply formation of complex will take place. Once these orbitals get hybridized of a particular shape and equal energy, then each vacant orbital will get attached to one of the ligand. So the finally what happens? These hybrid orbitals, each hybrid orbital undergo overlapping with the fully filled orbital of one ligand each, carbonyl ligands. So here we have these 5 DSP3 hybrid orbitals. So together with each of this DSP3 hybrid orbital, what happens? One carbonyl ligand will donate its lone pair to each vacant orbital, vacant hybridized orbital, so making 5 metal carbonyl coordinate bonds like this. So in this way, this pentacarbonyl iron is formed. Now, since the hybridization of central metal ion in this case is DSP3, so on the basis of hybridization, what will be the geometry of this compound? Geometry of this compound will be trigonal bipyramidal. You know, we have done in class plus one that geometries are always dependent upon type of hybridization, like sp3 tetrahedral, dsp2 square planar. So sp3d and dsp3, one of the same thing, so it will be trigonal bipyramidal. And if you look at the electronic structure of this complex, so you see there is no unpaired electron in this complex. All the orbitals have paired electron. So no unpaired electron, so obviously what will be the magnetic nature of this complex? Magnetic nature of this complex will be automatically diamagnetic. So therefore it is a DSP3 hybridized complex with geometry trigonal bipyramidal and diamagnetic in nature. So let us repeat once again. Today we have discussed ML5 type of complex, coordination number 5. Example is pentacarbonyl iron. In this complex, iron atom is present in zero oxidation state because CO is a neutral ligand and on the complex there is no charge. So X plus 5 into 0 is equal to 0, so you will find oxidation state of iron atom 0 in this case. So what will be the electronic configuration of iron in 0? 0 means iron atom. It is 3d6, 4s2, 4p0. So if you look at this complex, then CO carbonyl, it is one of the strong free ligand. I already taught you that what happens in case of strong free ligand. The strong free ligand has a special property that they always make the pairing up of electrons in 3D orbitals. It can happen from 3D itself, but it can also happen from 4s orbitals. So in this case, what happens? CO makes the pairing up of electron in 3D orbital. This 3D orbital, unpaired electrons also get paired, and two electrons from the 4s orbital, they also get paired up in 3D. So together with this pairing up of electron, finally what happens? You see that all these 8 electrons get paired up in 3D orbitals. And what is the result? One of the 3 orbital becomes vacant for hybridization and bonding. So one 3D orbital, one 4s, and 3 4p orbitals. So finally all these 5 orbitals get hybridized and undergo hybridization, give rise to these 5 new dsp3 hybrid orbitals. As these hybridized orbitals are formed, then formation of complex takes place. In this, what happens? With each hybridized orbital, one of the carbonyl ligand will donate a pair of electron to each hybridized orbital, giving rise to 5 carbonyl iron coordinate bond and a complex with the shape of trigonal bipyramidal. You know, in trigonal bipyramidal shape, what happens? Iron is lying at the center and 3 ligand will lie at the corner of 3 equilateral triangle. All these lies in one plane like a equilateral triangle, and the two ligands, one ligand lying above the plane and one ligand will lie below the plane. So this will be the geometry of this compound, trigonal bipyramidal pentacarbonyl iron. And once again, hybridization will be dsp3, geometry automatically becomes trigonal bipyramidal. In magnetic nature, if you look at, so then no unpaired electron in the electronic configuration of this complex. All the orbitals are paired. So obviously, if you look at this, no unpaired electron, so the magnetic nature of this complex will be diamagnetic in nature. So this is all about the magnetic nature of complex, that is diamagnetic. And ML5 type of complexes in our syllabus is only one, that is pentacarbonyl iron. So that's all with this. So further we will discuss about the ML4 type of complexes. So ML4 type of complexes. So in ML4 type of complexes, coordination number automatically 4. That means with one metal ion, 4 ligands will be attached. So the examples of ML4 types of coordination complexes in our syllabus are NiCl4, that is tetrachloridonucleate 2. Second is NiCN4, 2 negative, that is tetracyanidonucleate 2 ion. And third one is NiCO4, neutral. It's a neutral complex, no charge on it. So obviously the name will be tetracarbonyl nickel 0. Oxidation state in this case of nickel is 0. So these are the 4 complexes in our syllabus of ML4 type. So from which, first of all, we will go with the NiCl4. Tetrachloridonucleate 2. So what is the oxidation state of nickel in complex? If you calculate, all of you know how to calculate it, is +2. Nickel lying in +2 oxidation state in this complex. So the electronic configuration of nickel +2 ion, electronic configuration of nickel atom is, if you look at the electronic configuration of nickel neutral atom, it is 3d8 4s2 4p0. This is the outer shell configuration of nickel in neutral state, 3d8 4s2 4p0. If we lose 2 electron from the 4s orbital, so obviously what will be the configuration of nickel 2 ion? It will remain 3d8 4s0 4p0. So it is something like this.
Three D eight, one two three four five six seven and eight. Three D eight, four S zero, and four P zero.
So this is electronic configuration of nickel 2 ion. And in this case, if you look at the ligand, it is Cl chlorido. It is not one of the 4-5 strong ligands. So chlorido being a weak field ligand, it cannot make this pairing up. So in this case, these 2 unpaired electrons in 3d8 orbital will remain as such. No pairing up will take place. If this pairing up will not take place, that means no vacant 3d orbital. If there is no vacant 3d orbital, obviously then bonding will take place only with the s and p orbitals. You know, in 4 coordination number, 4 vacant orbitals are required. So obviously here these 4 orbitals are 4s and 4p. So in this case, what happens? 1 4s orbital and 3 4p orbitals, they will undergo hybridization known as sp3 hybridization takes place here. So 3d orbital does not take part in bonding, only 4s and 4p orbital, they take part in bonding. So this 4 orbital undergo hybridization to give rise to 4 new orbitals hybridized, and finally all these hybridized orbital will overlap with the 4 Cl negative ligands like this. This 3d orbital will remain as such. 3d8, and finally that we are having this 4 hybridized orbitals. So these are 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals. So together with this 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals, each one will overlap with the 1 Cl negative. That means each chlorido ligand will donate a pair of electron to this each hybridized orbital, giving rise to 4 nickel chlorine coordinate bond, and that results in the formation of a tetrahedral complex. Obviously the shape will depend upon hybridization. So the hybridization of this complex is sp3, and based upon the hybridization, what will be the geometry of this compound? Whenever there is a sp3 hybridization and all the 4 bond pairs are there, you know only one, that is tetrahedral geometry. That means nickel ion in center, and all the 4 Cl negative ions in tetrahedral shape, 109.8 bond degree bond angles. And finally we look at the magnetic nature of this complex. So it is tetrahedral complex, and magnetic nature, if we look at carefully, then there are these 2 unpaired electrons in 3D subshell. In this complex there are 2 3D orbitals, unpaired orbitals, electrons in this complex. Since there are 2 unpaired electrons present in the complex, so obviously what will be the magnetic nature of complex? It will be a paramagnetic complex. So finally what we have come to know from this, that NiCl4 is a tetrahedral and paramagnetic. Why I am saying this? Because in next topic we will discuss that NiCN4 will be a square planar and diamagnetic. Although they seems to be similar, but when we go with their hybridization and structure, that is totally different. NiCl4 is a tetrahedral and paramagnetic. NiCN4 will be a square planar and diamagnetic complex. In next lecture we will discuss that. So up to this, one of the ML4 type of complex we have discussed is tetrachloridonucleate 2. So 2 more we are left, that is NiCN4 and NiCO4. So that we will discuss in next lecture. So that's all up to this, Peter. Thank you to all of you.